this video, we visited the extreme habitats of prokaryotes that lived here before the advent of sex. We learned how these archaea and bacteria joined forces to form eukaryotic cells that invented sex. In this video, we'll go together on safari in southern Africa to meet the most advanced and dominant animals, the big mammals. Unlike all other videos in this course, you will hardly hear me, and I won't explain about the animals you will see. I will only tell you a bit about where we are. Don't worry, later in the course we will meet these animals again and again, and we'll learn in detail about the many aspects of their reproduction. But this does not mean that you are going to be idle. To the contrary, we have prepared a guidebook for the animals you might meet. Take a pair of binoculars, hop into our 4x4 and start filling out your checklists. Remember, a sighting is valuable only if we know when and where it was done. Every time you see a new animal, you will therefore have to stop me so that you can identify it. You will have to fill in when, the time of the video, and where you made the sighting. If you're joining us, we might need you to push if you get stuck in the sand or will have to change a tire. And you're also welcome to help with cooking dinner and setting up camp. Let's go! We landed in Windhoek, the capital of Namibia. Namibia is a huge country, 40 times bigger than Israel, and very sparsely populated. Much of the country is desert. These stunning dunes attract tourists. The Welwitschia, the evolutionary ancient and bizarre plant, is well adapted to the extreme conditions here. On our way, we will visit rock paintings that show that already thousands of years ago people were interested, just like you, in animals. At that time, animals were plenty everywhere. Unfortunately, today they are mainly restricted to reserves. However, on our way, we met these fascinating desert elephants that managed to live in these dry conditions, thanks to the wise leadership of the matriarch, which knows where to find water and food. Etosha is one of the most impressive reserves in Africa. Due to its arid nature, most animals congregate by water pools. I will shut up now and will let you enjoy and identify the animals. Some of the species here you will see in other places, but some you will see only here. Do you manage to identify them? Today we have a long drive to Botswana, the most animal-friendly country in Africa. It is not allowed to hunt here, and much of this arid country are nature reserves. We will visit Chobe, a small reserve packed with wildlife on a riverbank. I have to be careful not to get stuck in the sand, so I'm relying on you to spot the wildlife. After our adventures in Chobe, we are crossing today the border to Zimbabwe to visit Hawangwe National Park. Years of political instability led to neglect and decline in tourism. However, this is why Hawangwe, the biggest reserve in Zimbabwe, feels wild and primordial. We'll sleep here by waterholes so that we can watch the abundant wildlife day and night. This feels a bit adventurous, but in the tent on the roof of our car we feel rather safe. After all these arid and dusty safaris, we will finish our tour at Victoria Falls, one of the biggest waterfalls in the world. The source of all this water is in Central Africa, and it is of immense importance to inhabitants and wildlife alike. We hope that you enjoyed our trip and identified all animals. If you missed some, you have the movie and you can watch it again.